Hey everybody, it's Corey Ballard and I'm back again with another vlog. Not a vlog. I'm back with another video. Go ahead and like the video, share the video on other platforms, please. I need about 5,000 shares. I need comments. I need you to visit my blog, coreysong.blogspot.com, and visit me on all my other little social media and crap like that. So today I'm gonna be talking about going over, if you will, a little unsung Hollywood episode of Jasmine Guy. Jasmine Guy, and I watched this a long time ago, but to write my notes down, I watched it a long time ago. But I didn't get around to doing this video. Also, another thing is people, viewers, some of my videos, I apologize. I just want to make it clear that some of my videos, I'm uploading them at a sequence. So the reason I'm doing that is because I had already did some videos and I had spaced them out and stuff like that so they would come out so I wouldn't be having to do it every time manually. I could just have some stuff coming out. So some of the videos are out of order, so sometimes, like in my vlogs or something, if I'm talking about something I already talked about or didn't talk about or whatever, vice versa, whatever, you know what I'm saying, in some of my videos, if you watched all my videos before. So some of them, it's because some of them are out of order. So, but, you know, I'm going to try to start getting them back into more order sooner or later. But I watched this and wrote these notes down a long time ago. So, I might be forgetting some things, but I don't think I will, because I think I know. I wrote down a whole bunch of stuff this time, so hopefully it'll all come back to me. So this episode was about Jasmine Guy, who is best known for her role on the sitcom A Different World as the character Whitley Gilbert, one of my favorite shows ever. And this is about her life. So she had, she grew up, she had a black father and a white mother. I think, did they say she was born in New York or Detroit or something? I'm not really sure, 100%. She was born somewhere north and she ended up moving to Atlanta when she was a small child. And she was harassed and bullied as a child for her proper English because her father was a professor at, what is that school that's in Atlanta? Is it Clark? Clark Atlanta? Spelman? One of those. One of the schools. He was at a college. Or one of the colleges in Atlanta. He was a professor. So she, her parents were very strong about education and stuff like that. So living in Atlanta, and they were, maybe she was born in Boston, them being from the north and then also having those parents, for the parents that they had, her and her sister. She had a sister. It was her and her sister. She had one sister. They were harassed for their proper English. And so Jasmine Guy, she would begin, as a child, she would begin to imitate all the people in the city because she was so fascinated by them and their accents and things like that. And she had moved there to Atlanta and they were just different. So she picked up imitating everybody. And yeah, so she sang and she performed at church, and this is where she gained her love for the arts. She studied dance in high school. She joined the Alvin Ailey Dance Company and she moved to New York. Excuse me. Yep. Right out of high school, she did that. She moved to New York and started dancing. She was trained in like ballet and all that good stuff. She was, classically trained and stuff. So she was a dancer at heart. She liked to sing and she liked to, she was just a performer, all around performer. She auditioned for Fame in like 1980 or so, whenever Fame came out, close to that time. And this is where she met Debbie Allen, who she became a lifelong friend. Debbie Allen became her lifelong friend and mentor. After doing Fame for a year in LA, she moved back to New York. And because in Fame, she was just like playing a little bit part, I guess. And she wanted to be a star. She wanted to be a star. So she moved back to New York for her big break. She worked on Broadway in a few shows. And then she got a pretty big role in one of the plays, I think. One of the things on Broadway. I can't remember which one now. But she did Broadway for a little while. Then she auditioned for A Different World. The show that was the Cosby Show spinoff. And then she immediately got the role. They loved her when she did her audition. And she was the one. They said they had Ron, that was, Ron on, I don't remember his real name right now. But he played Ron on A Different World. He was on there giving an interview as well on the episode. And he was like, or was it Ron or was it somebody else? I think it was Ron. He said that she auditioned and then they sent her right into the reading where the cast was, like right on the spot. Like they loved her. She was the one right when she did her audition. And we know why, because she's so amazing in that role. What she did to get the role was she used her childhood talent for imitating everybody in her school of Atlanta. And she imitated one of her elementary school teachers. That's what it said. Character of Whitley was inspired by one of Guy's elementary school teachers. And so the rest is history. She went on Different World. A Different World was a big success. It was one of the number one rated shows on television. And Whitley was the star of the show after Denise left. After the first season, she was the main character of the show. And everybody loved her. It was just amazing. She played in movies, a few movies. She got her first role in Harlem Nights, I think. That was her first role. Oh, she also did, School Days. She did a couple of movies during that time. And then she started releasing music as well. Released an album. Had some success on the R&B charts and such. And she was a big, huge star. Like one of the biggest stars. What else? Some interesting things on there. Excuse me. So yeah, she was just a big star. She hated playing Whitley, actually. She didn't like her. She was snobby. She was stuck up. She was, annoying. She didn't like playing the role, and it was difficult for her to play, which was interesting. And then after The Different World ended, she was typecast heavily. And they actually said that she was offered a spinoff. It was going to be about her, Ron, Dwayne, and Freddie. So that was interesting. But she didn't want to do it anymore, so she declined, and the show did not happen. What else happened? So, yeah, so once after that show wrapped, she was pretty much typecast as Whitley. And so she took a back seat. She slowed down in the 90s. She was happy to not be Whitley anymore. She wrote a book. She appeared in the miniseries Queen. And then she started working in theater and moved back to Atlanta, her hometown, where she grew up. And she got married and had a child. And she was kind of relaxing and like doing a little local Atlanta theater. until the 2000s, and she landed a role on the sitcom Dead Like Me. So now she just continues to do theater. What else did I say? She divorced from her husband. She took a break. She moved back to Atlanta. Yeah, I wrote that down. I already said that. She started working in theater in Atlanta. She continues to, yeah. So she does various little roles on television and stuff like that. And she likes being in the theater. So that's what she's been doing a lot of. Doing a lot of theater. Where she can do all her... Show all her many talents. Her dancing and her singing and her acting and all that. So that's what she's doing. She's incredible and a legend. And I love her. And she's one of my favorite people. And that's one of my favorite shows. And the episode was really good. And go. So there you go, Unsung Hollywood Jasmine Guide. Those are the things that I learned. Those are the things that were interesting that I never knew that I did know. All that. So hopefully I explained it well and you learned something from what I have said. And let me know. Okay. In the comments down below and such, or message me or follow me on my social media. You can talk to me there. Go ahead and like the video, comment. Share it on other platforms. Visit my other platforms. Visit my blog, CoreySong.blogspot.com. I'll be back again with another video. Bye. Let me do my outro. Do, 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 do.